collar, like right here. So when you, the guy bars hang back here, okay? And then you have collars right here. Okay? Mm-hmm. Alright, so let me see your setup, okay? So same thing you just did with that PVC. Now, let me give you some pointers first, okay? I'll go ahead and just show you how about that. So let me step up to your bar. Okay, so you want to start feet underneath your hips. This bar should be centered over your shoestrings, okay? So over the tongues of your shoes. Now, when we deadlift, you want to make sure those hands are outside. I usually, like, thumb my calves, pull that barbell to my shins, wrap, and now I'm sitting down ready to deadlift the bar. So just like with the PVC position, shift the weight of your heels, bring your knees back out of the way, and one more extension. Okay, so now when I go down, break of the hip, my power position, right? Thighs back, knee to knee, set my butt down, pull and squeeze my glutes. Okay, so let me see you do. Okay, muscle memory, just let it take over. This is 65 pounds, stepping two off of my baby. So look here, come down, thumb your calves, pull that barbell to your shins, set your butt down, chest up. Okay, now, right here, strong back. Shift the weight into your heels, pull the bar, extension. All the way up, fast. Yes, perfect, do it again. Come down, knees back and out of the way. Yes, ride that bar path up and down. Beautiful, Derek, look at his deadlift. Thighs back, don't lose it. Two more. Nice, strong back, good job. Big, strong hips, one more. Drive, good, squeeze your glutes, and come down with the bar. Super sweet, super sweet. Good job, how'd it feel?
It was so weird, that was the first set I've ever done.
Yes.
First set ever.
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 Never done that motion ever in my life.
I love it, and it was spot on. So do it like that every time, and you're gonna be hitting PRs left and right. Okay, it looked really good. Things to think about. Do you ever go to the gym and lift weights?
Yes.
Okay, so you probably use the Smith machine, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the bar is set on bar path, okay? On the Smith machine. So we can't really have that form of the Smith machine because it's going straight up down bar path. You create your own bar path in CrossFit. So keep that into your mind. That is gonna help you when we go into cleans, when we go into snatches. Everything we do, we wanna keep close to the body. Okay? All right, good job. Go ahead and put knees out, squat. Gaze to the horizon, perfect. Lead up with those elbows and hips, drive it. There you go, do it again. Four more, perfect, spot on. Good job. Good, keep going. Hips open, feel the difference, keep going. Hips open, beautiful. Don't forget those elbows, good, one more. Elbows lead. Yes, good job. Did you feel that right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Okay, so now, pick up this bar. I know there's no bumpers on it, but I want you to pick it up from your deadlift. Okay, so feet outside, or feet stacked under your hips, actually, and then deadlift the bar up. Crack those thumbs. Crack your thumbs. There you go. Good. That was a good-looking deadlift. Now, we're going to clean the bar. There's some weight on this, okay? So, you're going to dip your hips, so there's your power. On that dip, you're going to extend high elbows and fast elbows. So it's high elbows, fast, okay? So, ready, dip, drive, high and fast. That's it, good. Now, stand up, suck your gut in. See if you can't rock that bar on those fingertips. Elbows come forward. Better, good. Set up and give me five of your best squats. Elbows lead. There you go, good. Again. Elbows lead. Yes, you got it. Good. Do it again. Elbows lead. Good. One more. Weight in those heels, drop the knees out, elbows lead, and rest. Return the bar to hips. Lower, set it down. Good job. How'd it feel?
Really awkward,
yeah. It's one of the most awkward movements, I think, that you'll do outside of a snatch. But this builds on your squat clean. So you're gonna do a lot of these. Okay? So, and it's just practice. Every time you get in here, you get better. Like I told you the handstand push-up story. Like I look back 2 years ago and I was just getting them where I could, like I said, do 10 without what I was falling out. You know, so good. Any questions?
No.
No, am I moving too fast?
No, I think more practice. I'm one person, I gotta do it over and over.
Yep, and that's what is good about CrossFit. You can always get the movement down and you can always make it harder, you know, and you can always get better. That's the thing, it's like there's no, you can never like not keep improving. That's like such a double negative sentence. But you can always improve yourself in here,
right.
You know, and once eventually you get your muscle ups, you think, oh, they're easy, throw away the vest on and make them hard again. Build that strength, so you're constantly improving.
Definitely.
Okay, go ahead and grab it here, just build strength, hip extension, hip flexion strength. We already talked about CrossFit being functional fitness, we talked about flexion extension in the hip. When we get into day two, and I teach you how to do kipping pull-ups, we're gonna be using that movement of the hip a lot. Kettlebells are a way to strengthen that movement. We do these a lot in here. And just a little bit of fitness knowledge, you can do more work, build more strength in a 30-minute kettlebell workout than you can run in the 5K. I don't know about you, but I'd rather do kettlebell swings than run a 5K.
Yeah.
Especially in this Florida heat. So when you start with the kettlebell, you wanna start, this is just giving you some pointers for other kettlebell movements that you do. I always tell my athletes, start with that bell in between those feet and then you're just gonna bend down. Those knees are gonna be open like a squat or like a kettlebell deadlift, okay? Now, you wanna think about rocking your hips, so we're gonna go into an extension and a flexion. So flexion is a decrease, extension is an increase. So start popping those hips. Good, good. Now, go ahead and put that bell down for me. You're not doing anything wrong. You're doing everything I want you to do. Except I want you to think about keeping that kettlebell just a wee bit closer to your body, okay? Tell my athletes, when they have a good kettlebell swing, you know it because it's gonna come back just like through the ass, okay? So you wanna keep it as close to you as you can. So let's pretend we have one. So this is this. Start here with your forearms on your inner thighs. Feel your forearms on those inner thighs. So on that extension, squeeze your glutes, and right there is gonna be your pull. Okay, so as it comes back, forearms slap your thighs, launch. So think violent hip extension, okay? Let me see you do it with the weight, okay? I want you to break it only at shoulder plane for right now. That's gonna be your Russian swing. Ready, and hips back. There you go, big hips, look here. Back, pull them back. Don't use your quads or your back. So rock. Hey guys. There it is, big hips. Good, pop and pull. Good, lengthen those arms. Long arms, yeah. Big hips, good, and rest, perfect. That, my friend, is an American kettlebell swing. A Russian kettlebell swing. When you do an American kettlebell swing, you're gonna go overhead. The majority of your kettlebell swings prescribed in CrossFit are gonna be an American kettlebell swing unless it's noted Russian. Meaning, if you are going RX or as prescribed in your WOD, you would wanna do an American swing. Now, when you do the American swing, you're coming straight up with your arms over your head and your ears are finishing in front of your arms. So like this. So if you notice, when I swing mine, I let that bell come straight down, flexion extension of the hip, pop it up. Okay, so let me see you try it, okay? So think, big hip. There you go, good. That's it. You see those ears? Ears finish in front of your arms. Punch that bell to the sky. Perfect. You got it. That's it. Rest. You got plenty to do in the lot.
Perfect.
Yes. All right. Now, feet up on ab mats. First time. Then, I was taught this. I teach this because you use more hip. I think it's a little bit more beneficial, actually. So always do this.
Okay.
You'll see people do this.
Okay.
If you're ever in a competition, they're going to do this. Your lot today is going to be 10-minute AMRAP. AMRAP meaning as many rounds of reps as possible. Okay? You're going to do 10 air squats. What we started with, the first squat. 10 AMRAP sit-ups, and then 10 kettlebell swings. Okay, so the way I have you set up here is going to be your station. Okay, so what that means, you can stand in between the kettlebell. This is how I set you up. A lot of that CrossFit is getting your timing down and your strategy. We're very competitive. We want as many reps around as possible. So you want to have an effective workstation. So basically, you don't want to air squat here. You don't want to come over here and do your kettlebell swings and then come back here. You have little movement. So this is your workstation, right? So you would start, don't squat like me, but say 10 squats, come down, 10 AMRAP sit-ups, stand up, your bell, there's your 10 kettlebell swings. So you see how I'm not moving, I'm making my time more efficient by staying in one station working. Okay, so that's how I have my athletes set up. Once you get more familiar, you'll do the same thing. You'll be in here like, oh, I'm gonna get this pull-up bar because I can put my box here and my barbell there. So you have like your little area. Because it's gonna help you reduce the amount of time that you waste.